Good morning, students. In our previous class, we got a detailed summary of William Wordsworth's lines written in March. And I hope that you all have well understood the poem. Now, student, today we are going to make a discussion on one very important point from this poem itself, and this is rhyming scheme. So student, what is rhyming scheme? In order to get the answer of this question, first of all we have to know the rhyming words. Here student, I have mentioned few words. They are crowing, flowing, defeated and retreated. If you follow that, the first two words, crowing and flowing, this sounds similar and their ending is also similar. Again, third and fourth words, defeated and retreated, are also sounds similar. So it means that I have mentioned two pairs of words. In the first pair, crowing and flowing, and the second pair, defeated and retreated, and both the pairs, the words are sounding similar, and these are our rhyming words, means the words that sounds similar. So students, the rhyming words are two or more words that have the same or similar ending sounds. Likewise, this one here also you can find that the ending sounds are similar, that's why they are rhyming words. So now students, can you find out more rhyming words from this poem itself? Yes. You can see that almost all the ending words are similar. Crowing, flowing, as I already shown you these two words. Then twitter, glitter. But sun is somehow different. It has no rhyming word here. Then against, youngest, strongest. Grazing, raising, but one, this has no rhyming word. Now come to the next paragraph. Defeated, retreated are rhyming. I have already told you this one. Then ill, hill, then unknown, it is not rhyming with any other words. Then mountain, fountain, sailing, prevailing, and again gun, it is not rhyming with anyone. So now students, now we will find out the rhyming word from this poem. Here I have taken the first paragraph at first. So here you can see that the first two lines, they have two rhyming words at the end, crowing and flowing. But the last word of the third line, twitter, is different. Means the first two lines have rhyming words. That's why we will mark them as similar. Means, and we will start marking them with the letters. And we will start it with the first letters, that is A. As both the first lines are sounding similar, that's why we will label them as A and A. Then again, the third and fourth line, teacher and glitter, again they sound similar, means they are rhyming words. But it is different from the first two lines. That's why, as we have marked the first two lines as A, now we will mark these next two rhyming words as B. Now we have got four rhyming scheme, AA, BB. Now comes the fifth line, the green field sleeps in the sun. So student, the word sun, it has no rhyming words in the poem. That's why we will mark it as a single letter with C, because A is B and B we have already used. That's why we will mark it as C. Now let's come to the next lines, youngest and strongest. Again they are similar in sound, that's why we will mark them with the letter D. Then comes the next lines, grazing and raising. Again, they are similar in sounds, so we will mark them with the letter E. And the last one, the word one, it has no rhyming word in the paragraph, so we will label it with all alone with only one letter, that is F, as E has already been used. So the poem, the first paragraph, we have labeled them as AA, BB, CDD, EE and F. Now let's proceed to the next paragraph. Like an army defeated, the snow had retreated. So here defeated and retreated, they again sound similar. So here we will label them as G, because student, in the last paragraph we have already used F in the last line. That's why we will use the next letter here, that is G. Again, come to the third and fourth line, ill and hill, they are rhyming. That's why we will label them as HH. Then the fifth line, unknown, it has no rhyming words. That's why it will be labeled as only one single line, and we will label them as I. Then come to the next two lines, mountains and fountains, again rhyming. That's why we will label them as with the same letter, that is J. Now come to the next lines, sailing, prevailing. Again they are same, so rhyming words, and we will label them with the same or similar letter, that is K. And the last line here, the last word is gone and it has no rhyming word, that's why we will label it as L. So student, after reading the second paragraph, we label the second paragraph as G G H H I J J K K L. Now student, let me read out the labeling of both the paragraphs together. A A B B C D D E E F G G H H I J J K K L. So students, you can see that in this poem I have leveled the lines with the letters on the basis of the rhyming words, and student, this is known as rhyming scheme. So it means that rhyming scheme is a way of describing the and words of the lines in a poem. Likewise, there, here you can see that how we have described the last ending words of the lines in a poem with the help of the English letters, and it is the rhyming scheme. And student, each new sound at the end of a line is given a letter. Means student, here itself you can see that defeated, retreated is similar, that's why we have labeled them as with the same letter GG. But again, ill is a new sound, ill and hill, that's why we will label them with another letter. So each new sound at the end of the line is given a new letter. And if an end sound is similar as the end sound of an earlier line, it gets the same letter as the earlier line. But this third point is not applicable in this poem. Means students, that suppose here defeated, retreated, or okay, you just take the third and fourth line, ill and hill. It's a third and fourth line, and it is labeled as H. But now, again, suppose in seventh or eighth line there is a word like still. So again, hill, ill and still will be same same words. That's why even though it will be in seventh or eighth line, means it is not in a continuation process, but still we will give them the label of hill and ill, that is H. So student, I hope that you have well understood the rhyming words. and rhyming scheme. And you I also hope that you have you can find out rhyming scheme and rhyming words from any other poem that you will read in your future. And student, at last, again I want to remind you the rhyming words that we have got in this line, in this poem, and they are crowing, flowing, titter, glitter, youngest, strongest, grazing, raising, defeated, retreated, ill, hill, mountains, fountains, sailing, prevailing. So these are our rhyming pairs of words, and our rhyming scheme is A A B B C D D E E F G G H H I J J K K L. So student, this is the end of our today's class. Today we shall not further describe anything other any other important thing, because this rhyming scheme is a very new thing for all of you, and for better understanding you need some time. So that's why this is the end of our today's class, and in our next class we shall discuss another important topic related to this poem. Thank you so much.